At this point in our journey, we want to configure our DOS system to connect to a network. This will allow us to share files, browse the internet, and connect to bulletin board systems. For this part of the setup, we will need a packet driver and an NDIS2 driver for the network card. There are three networking clients that we'll look at, starting with the Microsoft Network client. The installer package can be found on the NT Server 4.0 installation disk. Under the clients directory, we have MS Client, which contains another subdirectory called Net Setup, where we can run setup.exe. At the welcome screen, press Enter. Next, we can choose the directory to install the Microsoft Network client to. You may change the installation directory if you want, however, the default directory is fine. When ready, press Enter to continue. From this screen, we need to select the driver for our network card. The drivers on this list are very old, so chances are you'll need to select network adapter not shown on the list below. If so, point to the location of the NDIS2 driver. If successful, the name of the network adapter will appear on the list as shown here. Press Enter to continue. From the Set Network Buffers prompt, press Enter. And now we can create a username. On this menu, arrow up to Change Network Configuration and press Enter. We want to replace the IPX protocol with TCP/IP. To do this, press the Tab key and the highlight bar will shift to the top box. Arrow down to the IPX protocol. Then press Tab again and arrow up to Remove, then press Enter. We will now be prompted to select a protocol, which we can arrow down to TCP/IP and press Enter. Then highlight Network Configuration is correct and press Enter. Now highlight the listed options are correct and press Enter. For this screen, the path in the bar is correct. We just need to press Enter to continue. Remove any disks and press Enter to reboot the PC. Now when the PC starts up, there are a bunch of lines that scroll the screen, so you can't really read them. Also, we have a prompt for the username, which we can press Enter on. Then enter the password, which there isn't one yet, so just press Enter. Then we will be asked if we want to create a password. You are welcome to, but for demonstration purposes, I'm selecting no. The next step to achieving network connectivity is adding a line to our autoexec bat file for the packet driver. At the end of the path and file name, add int equals 0x60. 0x60 is the memory address where the packet driver will load. It is very common, however, your particular network adapter may call for a different memory address to be used. That information can be found in the README file included with the packet driver. Now to save and exit, then reboot the PC. To test network connectivity, we can ping the default gateway, which is 10.0.0.1. And we get a reply, so we know that it's working. Moving on, the next networking client we will look at is Microsoft LAN Manager, or LANMan for short. The installer package can also be found on the NT Server 4.0 installation disk, in the clients directory, and it is split into four directories, one for each of the disks. We can navigate to the disk 1 directory and run setup.exe. Here on the welcome screen, we can press Enter to get started. This screen is an explanation of how to navigate setup with a keyboard. When ready, press Enter to continue. At this prompt, We just need to verify that the install from directory is correct, which it is, and the destination directory is correct, which you can change it if you want to. Press enter when you're ready to continue. Now we get to choose the type of setup. For demonstration, I'm going to select LAN Manager Enhanced and press enter. At this prompt, we can change disk 1 to disk 2 and then press enter. Now we have a list of included network adapter drivers. These are for rather old hardware, so chances are you'll need to tab over to Other Drivers at the bottom and press enter. Now to point to the path where the drivers are. I have a disk I'm using, so I can point to A:, and press enter. If successful, you will see the name of the network adapter in the list. Highlight it and press enter. On this screen, we get to choose what protocol we want to use. Arrow down to TCP/IP and press the spacebar, then press enter. To confirm these settings are correct, press enter. For demonstration, I'm not setting a static IP address, so we can leave these fields blank and press enter to continue. Now to add a computer name and username. Then press enter to continue. At this prompt, I'm going to select no, because I do not have Windows installed, and then I will press enter. Here at the memory management prompt, I'm going to leave yes selected and press enter. At this prompt, switch disk 2 to disk 3, then press enter. The setup is now complete. We can press enter to exit setup and reboot the PC. To test the network connectivity, we can ping the default gateway, which is 10.0.0.1, and we get a reply, so we know that it's working. The third network client that we're going to look at is called MTCP. It can be obtained from brutman.com. Copy those files over to a directory of your choice on the DOS PC. I chose to put them in C:\MTCP. We need to change directory to MTCP, then key in edit sample.cfg at the prompt and press enter. This is the configuration file for MTCP. There's just one value that we need to change. Scroll down to host name and change the name to whatever you would like. I'm going to name the PC Retro PC. When finished, save the file as tcp.cfg and exit. The next step is to tell MTCP where the configuration file is. To do that, key in set mtcp/cfg equals, followed by the path to the file which we just created. In our case, that's c:\mtcp/tcp.cfg. Note that we will want to add this file to our autoexec.bat file, so we don't have to type it in every time we start the PC. Pro tip, you can create a separate batch file that loads the packet driver and MTCP, so you can run it when you want to connect to the network instead of every time the PC starts. To test network connectivity, we can type DHCP at the prompt and press enter. We have an IP address, so we are all set. From here, you can learn about browsing the web on MS-DOS or how to connect to bulletin board systems.